Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel irfancfps. First of all, I would like to thank you all for your immense support. We have reached 2100 subscribers. To those who haven't subscribed yet, I kindly invite you to join us for regular updates. So let's continue with our today's topic. It will be firefighting system installation details. In this particular session, we are going to discuss about the installation details for each and every equipment that is going to be used in the firefighting system. To make it engaging, I will pose questions between our session related to these details. Please check the NFPA codes and share your responses in the comment section. So let us start with our first installation detail, which is upright sprinkler. In our today's session, we are going to show you some pictures along with the installation details for each item or equipment so that it will be easy for you to understand. So coming back to our session, this will be the installation detail for the upright sprinklers. Basically, upright sprinklers will be installed where there is no false ceiling. So it will be installed below the roof. The minimum and maximum size below the roof for the upright sprinkler shall be in between 25 mm to 300 mm as per NFPA 13. However, if you have any obstructions, then you need to refer NFPA 13 for the distance from the obstruction to this upright sprinkler. So basically, here you can see a picture. We have shown here orange bulb. Basically, these bulbs color depends upon the temperature rating of the sprinkler. If you have red color bulb, then the temperature rating might be different, and if you have orange color bulb or green color bulb, the temperature rating might be different. You need to go through NFPA 13. I already posted regarding these sprinklers on my YouTube channel. You can just go and check NFPA 13 training module. See, basically these upright sprinklers will be mounted in an upright position on the piping. So second topic will be the pendant sprinkler. Basically, there are various types of pendant sprinklers available in the market. See, here pendant sprinkler means only this much, but if you want to add some finishing touch to that sprinklers, we can use Istrian plates for decoration purpose, or we can go ahead with concealed type sprinkler. Basically, concealed type sprinklers will be of much higher cost than the recessed type pendant sprinkler. So the selection of this particular sprinkler depends upon the project specification requirement. These sprinklers will be installed on false ceiling areas, even if it is tiles false ceiling, or in case of any other false ceiling, these sprinklers can be installed. Coming back to the firehouse cabinet detail, see, firehouse cabinet details or firehouse cabinets are available in various sizes in the market and also various types. For example, here you can see the installation detail of this fire hose cabinet. We have shown here 40 inch dia hose valve along with the hose rack. Here you can see one more valve of 40 mm dia. This valve can either be 65 mm or 40 mm. The selection of these fire hose cabinets, including the type of material for the door and also the type, the color, will depends upon the project specification requirement. Basically, the fire hose cabinets comes into class 2 type, and you will not have these valves installed in fire hose cabinets. However, the type of this cabinet will solely depends upon the project specification requirement. So this is one more type of fire hose cabinet. Here we have hose reel installed. Here you can see this is synthetic hose with rack. And with this hose reel, we have shown fire extinguisher as well. And also there is one more valve shown here. Hose valve to be used or should not be used depends upon the project specification requirement only. Extinguishers can be provided with fire hose cabinet. However, as I told you, everything depends upon the project specification requirement. This is the installation detail for the portable fire extinguishers. You check NFPA 10 for the installation height and share your reply in the comment section. I will wait for you. Regarding the extinguishers, as per NFPA 10, it should be UL or FM approved. However, it all depends upon the local authority as well, whether we need to go for UL/FM approved product or the local product. Basically, project specification will define the specification of the material and the type of product to be used in that particular project. This will be taken from the client before we proceed ahead with the material submittal or the procurement. So extinguishers can be provided with a cabinet. However, the provision of the cabinet depends upon the specification requirements only. Fire department connection shall be provided with a non-return valve or check valve. It is mandatory to provide non-return valve. And you can see the figure here. This fire department connection is provided with sign auto sprinkler fire department connection. Apart from that, you can see here you have two-way type. This is called two-way FDC inlet type. These fire department connections shall be provided with cap and chain. You make sure all these are available when we think about fire department connection. Basically, the fire department or fire engine will come and they'll put the hoses and supply the water to the sprinkler piping through this fire department connection. Here you can see flow switch detail. When flow switches are provided, they must be connected to fire alarm system so that once the flow starts from this, it will give signal to fire alarm panel. Flow switches are installed on piping. So automatic air release valves, these are installed on risers. Please share in the comment section the purpose of AAV per NFPA 13. And you can see here the gate valve, which is of 1 inch, is provided. Let me know whether it is mandatory or not as per NFPA 13. Here we are showing inspector test and test connection detail. This is the detail. However, here we have shown gate valve. So, but here you can see the image of test and drain valve. So let us know in the comment section whether gate valves can be used instead of test and drain valve in the inspector test connection. And this inspector test connection will be installed after the remote test sprinkler in the piping network. Please let me know the importance of this inspector test connection as per NFPA 13 through the comment section. See, basically this is the most important installation detail, which is zone control valve assembly. Zone control valve assembly consists of a control valve, a pressure gauge, a flow switch and the test and drain valve with sight glass. Basically here we have provided check valve as well. Just let me know as per NFPA 13 whether this check valve is mandatory to be used in zone control valve assembly. Share me your feedback in the comment section. See, this valve, as I already told you, it should be control valve. As per NFPA 13, control valve can be either OS&Y gate valve or butterfly valve. So which is the best option to go in our project? Just let me know. Or which is the best option to go in firefighting system? Let me know. Here you can see horizontal sidewall installation sprinkler detail. Let me know, is this distance correct as per NFPA 13 for the horizontal sidewall sprinklers? Sidewall sprinklers can either be horizontal type or vertical type. So our next slide will be for alarm check wall installation detail. Here you can see this is the image for alarm check wall assembly, which consists of pressure gauges, retard chamber, drain valve, and also alarm motor gong. Apart from that, you can see a gate valve, OS&Y gate valve installed below the alarm check valve. Check the installation height of this alarm check valve assembly as per NFPA 13 and share me in the comment section. I am asking you all these questions so that you can also learn by referring to NFPA 13, and we both can learn together based on your responses. So OS&Y gate valves are installed along with the alarm check valve assembly. This is the landing valve installation detail. Landing valves will be basically 2.5 inch, which will be installed in the staircase areas. These landing valves can be provided in the cabinet, but depends upon project specification requirements. Here you can find dry barrel pendant sprinkler installation detail. Various types of dry barrel pendant sprinklers are available in the market, but I have a question for you. Just check NFPA 13 where we are going to install this dry barrel type sprinklers in the project. Here we are going to look at swivel and clevis hanger details. This is the swivel hanger and this is the clevis hanger. This should be ULFM approved. And let me know whether these swivel hangers are mandatory to be used till 50 mm size as per NFPA 13. Or we can use clevis hangers in our entire project. Just share me in the comment section. And 15th installation detail will be about the fire hydrant. Basically, fire hydrants are provided with bollards. Apart from that, before the fire hydrant, we will install underground gate valve along with the valve box. Basically, you can see three figures here. This is the fire hydrant that can be dry or wet type. Selection will depend upon the project specification requirement. This valve is gate valve with post plate and screw and nut. Here you can see this is the valve box which can be operated through T wrench. This is the basic installation detail for the hydrants. Let us go to the next slide. We have post indicator valve installation detail. These post indicator valves are installed in underground piping. So underground pipe type depends upon the project specification requirement. See, you can find here the post indicator with post indicator valve. Let me know what is the purpose of this shut or open in the post indicator. These are also called as adjustable post indicator, since we can adjust these posts. 17th installation detail will be for the hose valve header. Here we have shown various hose valves in the header, and this is the image for that. Check NFPA 20 for hose valve header size and number of hose valves to be considered. Let me know on what basis these hose valves are selected. 18th installation detail will be for the supervisory or tamper switch, which will be installed on OS&Y gate valve. As you can see here, tamper switch will be installed on OS&Y gate valve. If you know the purpose, let me know on the comment section. And I have one more question for you. Can we install these tamper switches on wheeled type gate valve instead of OS&Y type? 19th installation detail will be for the pipe supports. See, basically, whenever we start any particular project, initially we need to take the material submittal, or we need to submit material submittal for each material along with the supports. Once those material submittals are approved, then we need to submit the method statement for the installation works along with the shop drawings for client or consultant approval. Upon receiving the approval copy only, we need to proceed ahead with our works. So basically here, this is what I mentioned, sprinkler system layout drawings and installation details for all the equipments, including support details, shall be submitted to client or consultant for approval prior to start the works. See, these are all images for the fire protection equipments. When this pressure switch is required, let me know as per NFPA 13. These type of fittings are called groove type, since you can see groove here. And this is the flow meter which will be installed in the pump room. Pressure reducing valve. This is called pressure reducing valve. Let me know when this pressure reducing valve will be installed as per NFPA 13. I request all of you to go through NFPA 13 and please share the possible answers in the comment section. I thank you all for watching my YouTube channel. Please comment and subscribe. Thank you so much once again. Bye.